Hello, and it's so good to welcome you to the St. Helens Carol Service. This year, coming to us in all our homes scattered around Stapleford and the wider area. And hello to you if you're linking in with this from much further afield. The St. Helens Carol Service for the past 11 years of my life here has been a highlight of my time as vicar. I've loved the full church, the sights, the sounds, the beauty of the Jesus story being absorbed into our lives. God taking his rightful place, calling us to listen to his wisdom, and whatever the world throws at us, to follow his path as light overcomes darkness. This year, despite the difference, all that is still true. We once again fill the church with song, with the help of our volunteer, socially distanced choir and musicians. We hope you will sing to your heart's content whenever you're joining in with this. Each item will follow on, carols, readings, prayers, talk, without further introduction. Don't be too sad, it's not the same. Remember, God is with us. Emmanuel.
Jesus Christ, your birth at Bethlehem draws us to kneel and wonder at heaven touching earth. Holy Jesus, to deliver us from the power of darkness, you humbled yourself to be born among us and were laid in a manger. Let the light of your love always shine in our hearts. Accept our heartfelt praise as we worship you. Guide and sustain us, that we may make the journey to adore you, Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the Father, full of the Spirit. Hear our prayer, receive our praises, fill our lives. Amen.
Once in royal David's city stood a Jesus Christ.
Do not be afraid, Mary. God is with you. You will give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High.
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not die, but have eternal life.
You are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May what you say to me actually happen.
For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that even though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, so that you might become rich.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favour rests.
He made his home among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Christ Jesus, even though he shared God's nature, he didn't hang on to that, but instead he made himself small like a lowly servant. Being made human like us, he humbled himself.
All this took place to bring true what the Lord had said in the past. The virgin will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us.
He was in the world, and although the world was made by him, the world didn't see who he really was. Even his own people didn't realise. But to all those who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave them right to become the children of God. Thanks be to God.
Starts with a young woman called Mary. She lived in the little town of Nazareth. One day, just in the normal course of the day, Mary was aware of someone with her. There in the light stood an angel of God. Mary was really frightened. "Don't be afraid, Mary," said the angel. "I bring a message of joy. You are going to have a baby son." But I have no husband, said Mary. He will be the Son of God himself, said the angel. You must call him Jesus. I will do whatever God wants, said Mary. And the angel went away.
At that time, Augustus Caesar sent an order that all people in the countries under Roman rule must list their names in a register. This was the first registration. It was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to their own towns to be registered.
Sir Joseph left Nazareth, a town in Galilee, and went to the town of Bethlehem in Judea, known as the town of David. Joseph went there because he was from the family of David. Joseph registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was now pregnant.
While they were in Bethlehem, the time came for Mary to have the baby, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. Because there were no rooms left in the inn, she wrapped the baby with pieces of cloth and laid him in a feeding trough. Thanks be to God.
in the fields.
An angel.
Glory of the Lord.
Very scary.
Do not be afraid.
Good news.
Great joy.
For all the people.
Today.
Your Saviour.
Born in the town of David.
Christ.
The Lord.
Know him.
Find a baby.
In a feeding box.
Great company of angels.
Give glory to God in heaven.
And on earth, let there be peace among the people.
Who please God.
Angels gone.
Let's go.
To Bethlehem.
Quickly.
Found them.
Mary and Joseph.
And the baby in a feeding box.
Told about the angels.
What they had said.
About this child.
Everyone.
Amazed.
Mary pondered all these things.
Shepherds.
Returning.
Praising God.
Thanks be to God.
I'm sorry.
Well, what a crazy Christmas we're having. Everything to do with our usual Christmas, whether we're Christian believers or not, revolves around getting together normally, doesn't it? The midwinter instinct to eat hot food, gather in the warmth, to turn on the lights, to find comfort in chocolate and mulled wine and share friendship and strengthen our family ties. Anything we seem to want involves mixing with others, dashing around the Christmas shopping, school nativities and shows, to celebrating with work colleagues. And all our church gatherings with literally, normally, thousands piling in through these doors each December. Not this time. Much of our lives has had to be rethought this year, hasn't it? It gets so tiring mentally and emotionally to try and sort of rewire our brains to behave and interact in a different sort of way. And it's something we're going to have to persevere for a while yet. It's that sort of sense of dislocation, everything being put out of joint, that is so disorientating. The life we normally have is sort of just there, but we can't have it. The Christmas we normally celebrate and the feelings we have about it have just been stolen from us. But there is a moment of truth to discover, away from the gatherings, away from the lights and the hearty atmosphere. In our emotions, in our sense of dislocation and alienation from the normal, we suddenly find ourselves right there with Joseph and Mary and the baby Jesus and what they were going through. I mean, just how did a newborn baby get to be laid in a manger, let alone the Son of God? I mean, what on earth was going on? Surely someone would have seen sense or had compassion to give Mary what she needed at such a time of complete crisis. We can forget the image of bustling Bethlehem with soldiers everywhere and loads of inns and no vacancy signs. Bethlehem was a small place with not many houses. There was no room for Mary and Joseph in the guest room, not because of the crowds, but because no one would give them the guest room. Mary and Joseph were left to fend for themselves amongst the animals in the lower part of the house, most likely because of the scandal her pregnancy had brought to Joseph's family. They suddenly found themselves alienated from family support and all that they would normally rely on in normal life. But this was now the new normal that they found themselves in, dislocated from all that they knew. All our Christmas carols and normal get-togethers any other year can make even the manger scene look cozy. It wasn't. It was traumatic and lonely, but then made mysteriously beautiful by the arrival of the shepherds and the news of the angels. In the midst of the awfulness of the moment, God assured them that he was with them and the plan of salvation was on track. For us, in 2020, the plan of salvation is on track still. God is with us in our dislocation and loneliness. For Joseph and Mary, by following God's plan, the old normal never came back. For us, like them, we have to trust God and reach out to him, rather than reaching out to a feeling and a way of life that may never quite return to how we want it to. Whatever opens up for us in 2021, look to God to light the way. Even if it is just a few days at a time. He gives us daily bread to survive and to share with others. There will be unexpected blessings to look for, like the shepherds arriving, and the road will travel on through times of joy and times of pain. Ultimately, crucifixion. Yes, we really do pray that this virus is finally nailed. and that will be followed by resurrection and everything being made new. So stick with God's plan. Follow Jesus with your life. No sulking, no drifting, no nostalgia for what we haven't got. Now is the time to step up and take the road God has for you and take your place in God's purposes for 2021 for you and your family.
Jesus was born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea during the time when Herod was king. When Jesus was born, some wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. They asked, "Where is the baby who was born to be the king of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and we have come to worship him."
When King Herod heard this, he was troubled, as were all the people in Jerusalem. Herod called a meeting of all the leading priests and teachers of the law and asked them where the Christ would be born. They answered, "In the town of Bethlehem, in Judea. The prophet wrote about this in the scriptures."
"But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not just an insignificant village in Judah. A ruler will come from you, who will be like a shepherd for my people Israel."
Then Herod had a secret meeting with the wise men and learned from them the exact time they first saw the star. He sent the wise men to Bethlehem, saying, "Look carefully for the child. When you find him, come tell me so that I can worship him too."
After the wise men heard the king, they left. The star that they had seen in the east went before them until it stopped above the place where the child was.
When the wise men saw the star, they were filled with joy. They came to the house where the child was and saw him with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. They opened their gifts and gave him treasures of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
But God warned the wise men in a dream not to go back to Herod, so they returned to their own country by a different way.
Thanks be to God.
The silent starry skies, holy.
Midnight clearly, star brightly, universe expectantly. Tonight we pray for our world, for the effects of this last year on every person in every country, for rest and healing. We pray as the vaccines are approved and rolled out, for restrictions and lockdowns, for kindness and understanding, and for your grace to be showered onto your creation. For 2021, that it may be a season of hope and joy. Midnight clearly, star brightly, angels gloriously, shepherds fearfully. We pray for those who fear the future tonight, for those struggling with worry and anxiety, with those who feel lost and alone. Draw near, Lord, with your love and hope and reassurance. We especially pray for those who have lost loved ones or have family and friends in hospital at the moment. Midnight clearly, star brightly, King searchingly. We pray as we are beacons of hope in our community of Stapleford that we will shine out for people to want to find the Christ child by seeing who we are and what we do, that they will see the work of your Holy Spirit, Lord, permeating everything we say and do. Midnight clearly, star brightly, stable humbly, family wonderingly. We pray for our families and friends that we may see this Christmas that they will be kept safe and see the hope that is within us and want to know more about our King Jesus. We have waited for you. Deep has been the darkness. We long for you to shine, right here among us where we are. If only you will come among us, we await the sound of a cry in the night, the joy that follows pain, the coming of hope. Midnight clearly, star brightly, baby lovingly, hopefully, savingly. Amen.
Thank you.
we really hope you've been blessed through joining in with this carol service. Thank you for taking the time out to go on this Christmas journey in word and song. If you are interested in becoming an active Christian, looking to base your life more around Jesus and wanting his love and power and strength to be yours, please do get in touch and we will help you forwards on this. The church's details will appear in a moment just after the final blessing and you can make contact that way. If you want to leave a Thanksgiving offering to God, you can head to our website as well and follow the Giving Online menu button and make a donation there. Details again in a minute about that. Well, this, as you many of you know, is my last Christmas here, and I want to take this opportunity to thank everyone in Stapleford for welcoming me and my family and making these years of my life a real pleasure. I hope and pray that something of what I have shared about the wonderful grace and joy of knowing Jesus and the revolutionary difference that he makes to our lives, I hope that some of that has rubbed off on you. And as I move on to minister in Broxtowe in Nottingham City, I take with me my happy memories and all the things you've taught me and blessed me with. So many, many thanks. Let's now share God's blessing.
May the Father, who has loved the eternal Son from before the foundation of the world, shed that love upon you, his children.
May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with joy and peace.
May the Holy Spirit, by whose overshadowing Mary became the bearer of God's Son to the world, give you grace to carry the good news of Christ.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.